Welcome everybody, you're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. Today we will be dealing with duplicate data using MySQL featuring Python. As always, feel free to hit me up here on Instagram and Twitter, as well as if you'd like to help support the channel. Here we go. If you don't have user credentials, I will put a card above for you to see how to do that. If you want to follow along with Python, feel free to pause the video and take these imports right here. I called in my config files real quick, which I needed to find in my working directory, but I wasn't sure which folders they were in. And then I called the credentials with the key value pairs that I stored here in this function that we're going to call and make our connection with, and then using a cursor allowing us to make our queries and send and retrieve data. If you're unfamiliar how this works, these queries would be very similar to if you're just doing pure MySQL terminal commands. These data are transactional data, and let's look at these real quick. We have this transaction ID here, which looks like it has two leading zeros followed by the customer ID, which is this. Here's your transaction date, which looks like it's just split from this, and then your products that were sold and the quantities. You're going to notice that we have repeating transaction IDs because you can buy multiple products in one transaction, so we need to find a way to deal with these data. What I decided to do is in pandas first look at how we can deal with these data, because it's a lot easier to look at duplicate values in pandas versus working with MySQL. If you're doing pandas, you would do something just like this, where you're calling your data frame and then you're doing .loc, then the data frame again, .duplicated, which is taking all the duplicate rows, and you want all columns. And I found that this is less than 1% of our data are duplicate rows, which is good. So we notice that here's a few of our duplicate rows that we have here. So it looks like all of the information is the same for the entire row, which is what we're looking for. If you're new to pandas, this is how you actually drop duplicated values. This is just printing off the first five entries. This would actually return to you unique rows. Since I didn't have these stored in a table, I created a table on the fly real quick, which you could see from this right here, where I'm just creating a sales transaction table with five columns, one of them of which is a date, and there's no auto increment for keys or anything like that. And then I sent it off, where you're just doing cursor.execute and then whatever your query is. If you want to run a query and show what you're doing, you'll do a fetch command, .fetch, all, .fetch many, etc. But I wanted to verify that the new table was created, which is this transaction table. We need to insert these data. So this is my insert statement here, if you're unfamiliar with this or just curious. Let's get into the duplicates now. There's a few things that we need to consider looking at duplicates. The first, do we want to look by row for one individual column that may be unique, such as an ID or some identifier to help us? Or do we have to work by multiple columns that we need to check for matching rows? This would be a case-by-case situation depending on what your data look like. For us, we can see the transaction ID is pretty useful, but we also know that from the transaction ID, we could have multiple products purchased. So maybe you need to use transaction ID and the item that was purchased. Now I'm running a query next that's going to return all of the duplicated. So what's going on with this? I'm taking all of the columns and I'm counting all of the columns from our data, which is this sales transactions table. And I decided to group by all of the columns. And then I want a count that's greater than one. So more than one entry for that. And then we call our cursor.fetchAll, which is gonna return our query. And I threw it in a data frame real quick so we could see what this looks like. So this notice something. I'm going to show you something first. So you're going to see that we have 73, which is counted from this fifth column. Let me explain what's going on with this. For this particular transaction ID that I highlighted, there's three occurrences of this. I took this column 5, which is all of the occurrences that we have, and summed them together, which ends up being 73. What this means is that while we have all of these entries, which are unique for the rows, which would be this, I'll show you real quick. For these 30 rows that we have, those are the 30 unique transaction IDs. And for each one of those IDs, we have duplicates that are counted here. With those duplicates, it's also counting the first unique occurrence. So it's basically 2, 1, 2, etc. I'll clarify this in a second so you can understand what's going on. But this is what's returned. So that gives us an idea of what's going on, and we're going in the right direction, but it's not exactly what we're trying to achieve in the end. So what I was trying to express above, the number of entries duplicated with the first occurrence included is 73 entries. You have 30 unique rows. Those rows are what are duplicated. Let's think about it like this from the standpoint of if we were using data frames, for instance. If we were to use the duplicated statement, and I do the long way so you can see what's going on explicitly. I'm taking every single column and I'm subsetting to find duplicate rows, basically forcing this to make sure it looks over all columns. Then what I want to do is I want to do a group by, and I'm taking the transaction ID and the customer ID. I could have changed this to actually the product sold. And I am counting all of the units sold. This is counting the rows, and that ends up giving you 43. So it's matching up with our query saying that we have the number of duplicates not including the first occurrence is 43. The number of unique rows, which are same as the first occurrence or unique rows, there's 30. You add both of those together, you'll get your 73. That's what happened. 43 repeats and 30 are the original first occurrence. And it was only printing off in the query everything combined. So you have to pay attention to what you're actually doing for your query, because it's a big deal. When you run that query, let's say we're selecting everything and counting all of these again and doing a group by for all of these columns. We're returning this value that we're returning is actually without the duplicate rows, which is interesting. So this query is actually producing unique rows, because if you compare it to the data frame version and you do drop duplicates, you get the same value. That's the way I checked to make sure I'm doing this correctly and I'm verifying what the query is actually doing. Then when we compare this to the original data, if you subtract those, you'll notice that you'll get back the number of duplicates, which will be your 43. That's the same thing as doing this right here for our subsetting to verify once more. Now, an alternative way to deal with duplicate data is using the distinct function. It's removing duplicate rows. There is a situation when you do not want to use this. I need to make this explicit. For instance, if you had employees or people having the same name, first and last, for example, you don't want to do it a distinct in that situation, because you're going to get rid of any other occurrence after the first, which isn't really what you want to do. And that's one consideration you have to think about. If you want to take that distinct, you can then use a temporary table to store the values and then delete the old table or drop the old table and keep this one, because now you would have your distinct values if you want to drop duplicates. In that case, we would do this simple query right here where we're doing a select distinct. We're calling all of the columns from our table sales transactions. That is going to give us our distinct values, which is 43 less than the original data set. Now, in order to remove the duplicates, we have a few options that we can do to work with this. If you're in a circumstance where you don't have unique IDs, then you have to be a little creative with the way that you approach this and solve this problem, because you're going to need to use multiple columns in order to make this work. For instance, we can do one way of solving this is using the temporary table to store our values using the distinct. We also have this, which I'm going to show as well, which is row number over partition by, then use a where clause. There's another thing, you can just delete things. I'm not going to go over just deleting everything, and that's not completely straightforward. So we're going to do our distinct, then we're going to create our temporary table that we're doing here, where this table is going to be this new name that we're having. It's going to copy all the distinct values from our table. Then what we can do is verify that our new table has the correct length that it should be, which is awesome. And then what you would do is you do a drop table. You would basically drop this table next, and then you'd be good to go. The alternative way that we have to work with this, we're basically going to use like row indexes, which are you're going to increment. And basically what's happening is when you're using the row number, each time we see the same row repeated, it's going to increment that number. So the first time it sees that row, it's a 1. If it sees that exact same row again, it becomes 2, and then 3, etc. And it does that for every single duplicate value. The first thing you're doing with this query is you're creating this basically variable name that's going to store your information like an alias. And you're going to do a select statement where you're taking everything and we're doing our row number, and then we're going to partition by our transaction ID and the product sold. That's what I chose. And then I need to order by, and I'm ordering by those same things. And this is our alias for our row numbers that we're creating so we can have a new column that's generated in our table. From there, we need to then do a select statement and call our temp variable. And I store this as a data frame, which is allowing us to create this data frame here. This data frame is storing everything now until we do something further. When you look for the duplicates here, we're looking for the size of this, which is greater than 1. Otherwise, that's what we're chucking out. So in order to do that and remove your duplicates, you run the same query as above, but instead of doing that last select statement where we're calling in our temp variable, you're replacing it with this statement here, which is this. And I didn't run that query, and this is the only thing you're changing right here. I didn't run this query because I didn't want to permanently delete it, but that's what you're trying to do in the end. Those are your two options of deleting duplicate data, as well as how we can investigate duplicate data and look at how many times it occurs or where it may be located. But as always, I'd like to say please like, share, and subscribe. And if you subscribe, turn on that notification bell. Feel free to hit me up on Instagram and Twitter, as well as if you would like to help support the channel, go on Buy Me a Coffee, and there's my handle. As always, I'll see you in the next video. Bye.